Oh, how the tables have turned. Departments across the nation are wanting accountability, which is a good thing. But for one supervisor with the NYPD, the introduction of body cameras has bit him in the ass. Hey guys, what's going on? I hope you are having a fantastic week so far. Let me know if you like the beard. I think I might keep it. Kind of like it. My department actually recently came out with a new policy allowing beards, which is awesome. It's 2021. It's nice to see departments catch up to that. There's a huge debate going on whether or not officers should be able to use their body cams to record whatever they want. A lot of departments already have policies and procedures in place to basically tell the officers when they're allowed to record, when they're not supposed to be recording. One NYPD officer actually took it upon himself to record his supervisor physically assaulting him. Why? For being late to work. The 28-year-old officer was approached by his 41-year-old lieutenant and actually taken into a room that had no cameras. Apparently, this officer was smart enough to figure out that in itself was maybe a red flag. So the supervisor begins yelling at him and then shoves the officer, and the officer starts recording. Now the lieutenant is claiming that they actually have a policy in place where the officer cannot film or record inside of the police department, stating that the officer broke policy by recording him. The first part of this video does not have sound, and let me explain why. A lot of body cams are built in with either a 30-second to 60-second buffer, which means it's constantly recording, but every second that it records, it's deleting a second from 30 seconds ago or 60 seconds ago. This means if something major happens in front of the officer, they can reach down and activate their body camera, and it has actually captured 30 seconds or 60 seconds prior to that. The problem is that these cameras don't record audio all the time, so usually whenever you hear the audio kick on, that is the moment that the officer has actually activated their body camera. It's a super handy feature to have because it's almost like going back in time and being able to capture an event that normally you would have been like, damn, I really wish I would have gotten that on camera. So anyway, this officer activates his body camera and the lieutenant notices that he has turned it on. The lieutenant then has the nerve to slap a write-up reprimand on this officer for discourtesy. Wait a minute, are you serious? Discourtesy? Discourtesy was you putting your damn hands on this officer. That's like deciding to slap somebody and when they slap you back, it's like... Now, before people start going off in the comments, this is actually a completely logical thing not to be recording inside the police department because you don't want to capture any sort of sensitive information. What if you have a witness to a shooting? You don't want that information to become available to the public if they are trying to stay anonymous. Or there might be paperwork or other sensitive information in the background that's not supposed to be public knowledge. And because most body camera footage is available through open records once it is downloaded to the server or however that department does it, that's why they don't like officers recording inside the station. But a former NYPD captain who is now a lawyer has spoken up and said, "This rule goes out the window if an officer feels threatened." The former NYPD captain then went on to say that once the supervisor physically assaulted him, he was no longer a supervisor. At that point, he was now a threat. I know there might be some old school cops that are watching this saying, "Oh, here we go, suck it up, I had it worse back in my day," so on and so forth. I mean, come on, it's not like you got punched in the mouth or anything, right? But let's be honest with ourselves and admit the fact that no occupation should allow supervisors to physically attack their subordinates, all due to being reprimanded for being late to work. Body cameras have definitely changed the game for law enforcement. It not only tells a story on the street, but it also tends to keep people honest both behind and in front of the badge. I can't tell you guys how many times I have shown up on a call and I watch people's eyes, I watch their hands, and a lot of times I will see them look down at my body camera and it's like they just chill after that. Like they don't want to do anything stupid on camera because they know there's no way they are going to be able to deny that in front of a judge. The new body cameras that my department got issued a few months ago are actually really cool, and they are a huge step up from what we had before. It's called the Axon Body 3. It's the same company that owns Taser. Arming your Taser, turning the lights on in your car, or even taking your gun out of its holster, which has to be modified when you go through this class, any of those events will trigger your camera to start recording. It also has built-in GPS that supervisors and dispatchers can use to know where your location is at all times. If the camera is in standby mode, which means it's not actively recording, it updates your GPS location every 30 minutes. If it is actively recording, I believe it's every 30 seconds, but that can probably be changed. I'm sure somewhere in the system it can be changed. Not only that, but as a supervisor, I can log into this website, which everything is cloud-based now, not local server-based, but I can log on and I can watch. I can live stream what my officer is seeing in real time if their camera is recording. And before someone asks, no, a supervisor cannot activate the camera, make it run, make it record, or anything like that remotely. The camera has to already be activated in order for them to be able to connect to it. Yes, I went so far as manipulating the HTML code on Axon's website to see if there was a way that I could circumvent this, even when it's on standby mode. Thankfully, it didn't work, and the instructor gave me a funny look during the class, but hey, it was worth a shot. At least now I know my department can't record me while I'm going to the bathroom. So the way it works is you detach it from your body, and there is a huge docking station at the police department that's hooked in through power as well as Ethernet. As soon as you plug your camera into the docking station, it has several slots in it, so anybody at the department can just go and plug it in. They can go and do their reports, and while they're doing their reports, it not only charges the body camera, but it also uploads all the videos to Axon's service online, which is evidence.com. This is extremely beneficial because the last set of body cameras we had, which are still in use in most departments right now, you actually had to manually plug it into the computer. You could control what videos you wanted to delete and which ones you wanted to send to the server, but now all of your videos go straight to the server, and you don't have any control over them. So that adds another layer of accountability, I think is a good thing. So again, now everything is saved through Axon's evidence.com. So for all you new supervisors in law enforcement out there, be careful what you do, because members of the community are not the only ones recording you now. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. I'm so glad to be back on here. I am going to have a lot of time this week. I got a lot of things going on, but I'm gonna have time to do a live stream. So join us tonight for a live stream. I'm planning on doing at least two this week, if not more. But either way, I have a whole new setup. I've amped it up. This is gonna be a whole new experience. I really wanna see you guys there. So if you're able to tune in tonight at 8 o'clock, join us for a live stream, and we're gonna have a ton of fun. I'm gonna be answering questions. I've added some like fancy overlays and things like that. Like events will trigger when certain things happen on the screen and stuff. So I'm hoping to have a little bit of fun with it. I am also using my green screen. So I'm not sure if I wanna put myself on a beach or downtown Manhattan, I don't know. But tune in, because it's going to be fun, I guarantee you. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your week, and I look forward to seeing you guys very, very soon.